Thanks for joining us for this edition of the show. You know, just recently, our entire school district went through a process called accreditation. It happens every 5 years, and an organization called Advance Ed comes and visits our schools, our administrative offices, observes our students and our teachers, and we'll tell you what their findings are when they actually gave our school board a report on everything they saw and how well we educate our students. Plus, we'll talk to one of our Horry County Schools alumni who came back to Loris High School, her alma mater, to talk to those students there. She is now a well-known author, but she had a lot more to say about things other than writing. At a recent Horry County School Board meeting, the Advance Ed Accreditation team presented a report on how we're doing as a school district educating our students. The team, headed by Dr. Steve Obor, visited schools, took a look at strategic planning meetings with our teachers and administrators, and spoke to district officials about how we work together as a school district.
Advance Ed is a worldwide accrediting. We've been doing it a long time. We have two corporate offices. We have one in Tempe, Arizona, and we also have one in Alpharetta, Georgia. I've been doing the lead work for 5 years. We now accredit a lot of systems like here rather than school by school. We come in and in some states we are the accrediting arm for the state. South Carolina I think is moving that direction, but we're by choice. Horry County decided to call us in because they wanted that rubber stamp that says that the excellence is here. Every 5 years we make sure that these schools have to be reaccredited, which is why we're here. Initial ones, obviously, it's a start. And then there's checks along the way to make sure that what we want them to do to meet and comply with our standards continues. So it really is a check and balance, but it's vested in continuous improvement. And today it's tough. Today, sometimes, if you're lucky, to predict tomorrow in schools. But this at least gives them direction. And what we see in a lot of cases, because they have to go through quite a bit to put this together for us, we see that being a benefit as well.
Dr. Obor says his team spent a lot of time observing our students instead of just our teachers.
But we look at it as an overview of differentiated instruction. We watch the students, so you know, in the classroom. We do not do teacher evaluation. This is watching the student. It is not teacher evaluation. It is not. It wasn't designed for that, and it isn't. We look at 7 learning environments, and they're all through the eyes of the student. So when you see us sitting in those classrooms, we certainly see the teacher, but we're watching the students. It's through their eyes, such words as student understands how this project is scored. Student is, well, it's from their eyes. So we spend 90% of our time paying attention to what the students are doing.
During the board meeting, Dr. Obor presented his team's findings and announced that Horry County Schools earned accreditation by meeting and at times exceeding Advance Ed expectations and goals.
Their parents should be very happy. The community should be very happy.
The final stage in the accreditation process happens in June when this Advance Ed team submits their findings on Horry County Schools and their decision that our school district has earned accreditation. And student success beyond our classrooms, even after they've graduated, is something Horry County Schools takes very seriously. And one of our Loris High School alumni is just an example of one of those success stories. T.I. Lowe is a graduate of Loris High School. She's also a very successful writer and author of several books. And she came to speak with current Loris High School students about much more than how to write or become an author.
And I told them today, I said, I want you to take 2 things away from that. Number 1, don't wait as long as I did. And number 2, it's never too late to do so. I had several mentors through elementary school, middle school, and high school, right here in these same schools, the same halls that they're walking in. And if it weren't for them, always encouraging me.
Most things don't come easy, and that most things are there right in front of us, but we don't realize that it's there until people tell us more about it.
If you'd like to check out some of the novels that T.I. Lowe from Loris High School has written, just check them out on Amazon. And thank you for taking time to learn a little bit more about your school district. As always, come with us next time we take you inside Horry County Schools.